Welcome to KA. We're all here because we're not all there. Who would like to go first?
Hi, everyone. My name is Ben, and it has been 284 days since my last kill.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, I'm Sophia Jessica, and welcome to the Fan Carpet.
I co-wrote it, and it was based on a scene in a film we made quite a lot of years ago, and it was something we kind of always wanted to explore again, myself and Elizabeth Morris. So kind of just one of those things, like busy with other projects, and then the opportunity came around to kind of, you know, develop the script and make the film. So that was how it came about. I think it was a happy coincidence, to be honest. It's not something we kind of set out to do. It was just, I always thought when we made the film that the scene was in, that it was a really interesting idea, and we thought we should definitely explore it in future years. So it was just trying to find whether do you do it as a horror film, do you do it as a thriller, do you do it as a comedy. So it was just kind of nailing that down first and foremost.
I am a co-writer on the film, as well as playing one of the leading roles. It's a concept that Martin, the director, and I came up with about 8 years ago. And it's been a process since then, really, yeah. In one of our first features that we wrote together, there was a standalone scene that we always referred to as the Killer's Anonymous scene. And it's something that we always planned to revisit, and here we are. It's tonally very different. The original idea was very satirical, much more comedy-based. Tonally it's taken a bit of a different direction, but the initial idea is still there.
It's a very different character. I've not really played this sort of thing before. He's basically a British sniper, and like with all the killers, he has a problem with killing. He has an addiction to it, and they meet and they go to this basically an AA meeting every week, and it was just a really different role, and it was something that I'd never really got to play. And we got to do gun training and hand-to-hand combat and all these things that just really good fun. So it was there was a lot of elements really that interested me in this. I've worked with Martin Owen, the director, before. We did a film a couple of years ago, and fortunately we got on really well. And when Martin was writing this, he kind of had me in mind for a role. It was a smaller role. It was actually the role that Jessica Alba ended up taking. And then he basically crowbarred me into one of the leads, and we did a load of screen tests and auditions and stuff, and just ended up on that.
God, I'd say from the very, the original conception of even the idea until now, it's been years. I think it's been maybe 2.5-3 years since the idea was picked up, and we knew we had some funding there and we could go forward and take it into production. So, you know, it does, each thing does take up of years of your life, which means, you know, when it all kind of comes to fruition like this, it really does feel amazing. Yeah, it's going back to, I guess, that very first idea that we had. I don't know if we really pictured it being here, but it's very humbling and very, very grateful.
Great, yeah, fantastic. Lovely cinema. It's actually the first time I've been here, so it's nice. Lovely place. Very, very impressed.
That's a really hard question. I get asked that quite a lot. It's like being asked to choose between my children. I think the process of acting, getting into a character, being on set is probably where I'm happiest, but also the kind of the solitude of writing can be a very cathartic experience as well. So the two are so different, I can't choose. Sorry.
Crazy, man. When he came onto set, it was just a really surreal moment, and just really great to be a part of such a brilliant cast. Obviously that is one of the things where I came on board quite early on, and we kind of to and fro with different parts and who was going to play what, and then landing on Gary Oldman and Jessica Alba and Tommy Flanagan and all these people. Big fan of Tim McInerney as well. Like, I used to love Blackadder as a kid. So like all these people, just getting to work with that standard really ups your game, and it's just a challenge really. So it was wicked.
Usual process really. Casting director sent it to them. They really responded to it. I had a quick conversation with Gary and Jessica. You know, kind of talking through my vision for the film, and then came on board. Very simple. It was worryingly painless.
I mean, I really enjoyed it. Yeah, it's a great genre to be a part of, and I just like to play different parts. I like to play, hopefully I do something and people don't necessarily recognise me as that character, so anything that's different really, and I get to push myself. And also working with, you know, if you're working with this sort of cast, that's always a draw.
Incredible, yeah. It's just having these people come on board and kind of having faith in our product and our story and what we've been working on for so long. It's again, it's just a very humbling experience. We're incredibly excited, and they've been amazing to work with as well.
Yeah, I think we can definitely do some more work together. Actually, Goldfinch, who own Bird Box, we actually made another film, which is in post-production at the moment, actually, called The Intergalactic Adventures of Max Cloud. It's a bit of a mouthful, which is a sci-fi action comedy set in 1990. So completely different to this. But that's a few months away, yeah. It's kind of hush-hush. I've not been told what I can and can't say, so obviously keep it stum.
I've just got my own feature script. I've got a producer attached and one of my favourite authors attached, so yeah, we're kind of in those beginning bubbling stages of my next feature, which I've written, and I'm going to try and muzzle my way in there on screen as well, if they let me.
I'm literally in prep at the moment for another film, which I'm directing for Sky Original Film. It's a remake of Oliver Twist, like a modern day adaptation, and it's like a heist version of Oliver Twist. It's kind of strange. We've got Michael Caine, Lena Headey, and Rita Ora. So it's a cool, it's an interesting cast. I'm looking forward to working with him. He's kind of on the list of people that I wanted to work with, and it was quite fortunate that Gary Orman and Michael were both on that list. So yeah, lucky, very lucky. She's great, and it's going to be good for her to do, a different. It's one of the lead roles in the film. You know, she kind of really, really is behind it, has put the time in, and I think he's going to deliver something pretty great.
I've got a film called Max Cloud, which is it's about a 16-year-old girl getting sucked into a computer game. And when she goes into the computer game, she becomes me. So I have to basically embody a 16-year-old girl. That was a challenge. So that's coming out, I think, next year. And then I've also done a World War I film called Clay Kickers, which obviously completely different again. That's based on a true story, and that comes out next year as well. I'm a northern miner that gets dragged down to the front line, and basically we dig a tunnel underneath the enemy lines and come up. And it's a crazy true story that I wasn't aware of, and reading the script was just like, this is insane. This actually happened, and it's strange that it's not a bigger thing. It's probably my lack of history, to be honest. I'm not very good with history, but probably lack of knowledge there. But yeah, just great to be able to do a true story. You're playing a real person. That is, it always makes it a bit easier, I think.
Let's go with Killers Anonymous 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's so hard to say. It's incredibly hard to say. It'd be, you know, to see a sequel, maybe even a prequel, would be amazing. But we shall see.
Thank you for watching The Fan Carpet. Please follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram for more content next time.
You forget how to live for anything else.
What do you think, Marcus?
I think I'm stuck on a rooftop with a bunch of dodgy Bond villains.
Thank you for watching The Fan Carpet. If you like this video, be sure to click that thumbs up button at the bottom of your screen. And also be sure to subscribe to The Fan Carpet YouTube channels. They're absolutely free. That's so much fun, too. Be sure to check out the official website, thefancarpet.com. Also, you can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram to stay up to date with reviews, competitions, the latest news, and so much more.